Hello, and welcome to Lab. Today we're going to do Experiment 9, Gas Laws. This one has a little bit detailed setup, so we're going to do that first. I'd like you to be my lab partner, and I'd like you to follow along in the lab manual. We're going to attach a ring clamp to a ring stand. We'll adjust it in a minute, but it needs to be fairly low, approximately the height of the bowl that we're going to be using. Then we're going to be filling this bowl to about 1 inch from the top with tap water. And we're going to turn this ring stand around so that the ring is over the bowl of water. And we're going to move and clamp the ring so that the clamp is right on top of the rim of the bowl. Next, we're going to fill this bottle of water almost all the way to the top, and then we're going to make a dome of water with the DI water bottle. When we displace the water, this is how we're going to measure the gas that is evolved. We're going to put a dome of water on the top. And then we're going to take the fat end of a rubber stopper and put it over. This is probably the most tricky part of the procedure. So if you can do this part, the rest is easy. We're going to hold very carefully, very tightly to the stopper, and flip this upside down and maneuver that bottle through the ring. And once it's in the water, you can remove the stopper. And we're just going to let that sit. Sometimes it's helpful to put a wet piece of paper towel so it doesn't slip, but it looks pretty good right now. There should be no air bubble or a small one. I do not have any in this one, and that is it for inverting the water bottle. We're going to put this tube in the mouth of the water bottle. So you can just lift it up and maneuver. That piece in there. And I guess this is where right now, I'm just going to leave it here. I'm going to get some wet paper towels so this doesn't slip, and our setup is done. In step two, we'll connect our aspirator from the side arm of our water spout, and we'll put the free end in our bowl. And once our reaction goes, we are going to be just turning on the aspirator by turning the water on just a little bit, just so that we don't overflow our bowl. And in step three, it says to obtain 50.0 milliliters of DI water, which I've done, and add to the Erlenmeyer flask. And then add 3 scoops of yeast. This is going to be our excess reagent, so it's Doesn't really matter how much we add. One, two, three, and we'll leave that stoppered. In the next step, we'll dispense 20.0 milliliters of this hydrogen peroxide unknown to an Erlenmeyer flask. So first we lift up gently on the barrel, and if there's a waste drop that comes off, we'll get it in our waste beaker. We'll put our Erlenmeyer flask underneath and press down gently. We'll stopper this immediately, and we'll proceed to the next step quickly because hydrogen peroxide does decompose quickly. Now we'll add our unknown hydrogen peroxide to our reaction vessel with the yeast and water in it. And we'll let that go for a little while. Give this a swirl. And it looks like our reaction is complete. So what we'll do now is we need to equalize the level of the water in the bowl and the water in the bottle. And that will ensure that our pressures are the same. And I'm going to do that first by removing the delivery tube so it sits a little bit lower. And then I'm going to, looks like they're about equal now, and I'm going to move the rubber band to that level of water in the flask, and then I will remove it. And you may want to put the stopper on when you're removing it. You still have a good amount of water left in the bottle. And that may overflow this red bowl here. Okay, it looks just about equal here. And I am going to remove this. And the rest of this water can go down the drain, or I will just fill it to dump it to where that line is. If you overshoot it, you can always add a little water. And then we'll measure it in our large graduated cylinder. And this will represent the volume of gas collected. In the next part, we'll react aluminum foil with hydrochloric acid. We're going to do the same setup as we did before, filling this with water and inverting it into the full bowl of water. And I'd like you to obtain 50.0 milliliters of DI water in an Erlenmeyer flask and also weigh a 4x4-inch square of aluminum. I've obtained 25.0 milliliters of 6 molar hydrochloric acid. I'm going to add that to my flask. And then I'm going to take the aluminum foil that you've weighed and tear it into four pieces and kind of crumple it up into loose balls. And we'll add these to the flask. This reaction takes quite a while. So now is a good time to do the calculations for the first part of this experiment. After about 15 minutes, the aluminum is starting to react with the hydrochloric acid. You'll see some generation of hydrogen in our collection bottle. And this whole reaction will probably take at least another 10 to 15 minutes. It looks like our volume in the red bowl is getting kind of high, so let's turn on our aspirator. And we'll take down the volume a little bit. You can also see that we've got a pretty active reaction going in our flask, and the hydrogen is bubbling into our collection bottle. We're no risk of overflowing now. It looks like our reaction is complete now. So I'm going to equalize the volumes, the volume of the water in the collection flask and the volume of the water in the red bowl, so that the pressures outside and inside are equal. And I'll move the rubber band down for that. And then I'll remove the bottle, and we can measure the volume of the liquid. And let's read this volume. Now that we're done with the experiment, we need to clean up. Everything can go to waste here and put all the equipment in the center so that it's ready for the next group. Thank you for being my lab partner.